Good morning. I welcome you all to the series of lectures on thermodynamics. Today we are going to discuss about the first law of thermodynamics. Consider a system which is highly insulated, containing definite quantity of mass of water, whose temperature is same as that of atmosphere temperature T1. And to measure the temperature of the water, thermometer is placed, and this is paddle wheel and the pulley and the weight. Initially the water is at the atmospheric temperature. Now if I give some certain amount of work through the pulley and through the paddle wheel, the temperature of the water rises to the T2, which is more than atmosphere. If I represent this 1-2-2 process on xy coordinates, this is xy coordinate. So this is the system initial state of 1 and this is the final state, and represents some amount of work transfer. If I give work transfer W122 and the system is reaching the new equilibrium point, that is 2, where the temperature is T2, and the amount of work transfer to the system can be identified or can be measured by the lowering of the weight or fall of the weight. The fall of the weight represents the work transfer to the system. This fall of the weight will drive the paddle wheel through the pulley. Now if the insulation is completely removed and the system is interact with the surroundings, and heat transfer takes place from system to the surroundings till the system reaches to same initial temperature of T1, and that means the system again come back to the same initial point by following the process 2-2-1. Now 2-2-1 gives heat rejection, and if you observe in a deeper way, the amount of heat transfer is completely proportional to the work transfer W122. That proportionality can be called as Joule's equivalent of mechanical equivalent of heat, or Joule's constant, or mechanical equivalent of heat J. Now if I write this for this combined together, 1-2-2 and 2-2-1 combined together called the cycle. For a cycle, you can write cyclic integral of dQ equal to cyclic integral of dW. So that means amount of heat transfer is equal to amount of work transfer for a cycle. For example, let us consider a system and it is interacting with the number of work transfers and number of heat transfers, like W1, W2, W3. Then if I apply first law of thermodynamics for a closure system, so Q1 heat supplied to the system is positive. Cyclic integral of delta Q equal to integral of delta W. That means cyclic integral of heat transfer equal to cyclic integral of work transfer. So Q1 heat supplied is positive. Q2 is also supply, heat supplied is positive. Q3 is heat rejection, it is minus negative. And W1 is work supplied to the system, it is minus. And work done by the system, that is positive, and work supplied to the system is again minus W3. So that means cyclic integral of heat transfer equal to cyclic integral of work transfer. And if, for example, if it is for closed system, and you know it is for cycle, for example, if heat and work interactions are involved when the system changing the state from state point 1-2-2. For example, if I represent the same coordinates xy, for example, this is the initial point 1 and this is the final point 2. In this process only, that means from 1-2-2, the system is interacting work as well as heat, then we cannot write cyclic integral of heat transfer is equal to cyclic integral of work transfer. And this is for a closed system operating for a cycle. If it is a change of state, that means for only one process and both heat and work interactions are involved, and I cannot conclusively tell that heat transfer is equal to work transfer. But it is not like that. But so, you know, when one process takes place from state point 1 to state point 2 containing or involving both heat and work transfer, the net energy is stored in the system, which is equal to internal energy, which is also called as internal energy, or we simply call it as energy of the system. Then the equation becomes Q is equal to, or the difference of heat transfer and work transfer is equal to change in internal energy, or simply energy of the system. So Q equal to W plus delta E. So this is the first law of thermodynamics for a change of state or simply for a process. This is both are first law of thermodynamics. This is for first law of thermodynamics for closed system, and this is for, you know, cycle. This is into cyclic integral represents for cycle. But Q is equal to W plus delta E. This is also a first law of thermodynamics, but for a process. See, zeroth law of thermodynamics introduce one property called temperature. This is first law of thermodynamics. This is also introduce one property called internal energy. Thank you very much.